Hey everybody, this is Lorenzo Valoria from GamesRadar.com, and I'm checking out Fuse, and I'm here with
Brian Allgaier, creative director.
Tell us a little bit about the game and what we're showing off today.
Fuse is a four-player cooperative game. It's got a story-driven campaign, and we're showing off a new mode called Echelon. So essentially, the whole game revolves around this alien substance called Fuse, and it's class-based. So each operative in the game has their own unique weapon and their own unique progression tree. So for instance, we've got Dalton Brooks, who has the mag shield that can protect himself and other operatives from bullets. We've got Nia Devereaux, who uses a warp rifle that creates singularities and can demolish multiple enemies. She can also go invisible. We've got Izzy Sinclair with her shatter gun that can crystallize enemies, and she uses the med beacon to heal enemies. And then we've got Jacob Kimball, who fires out arc shot bolts that can pin enemies to walls, and then he can also create burn damage. And all of these weapons work really well together to make the team more powerful and greater than the sum of their parts. So this is a fun dynamic that works together both in campaign mode and in echelon mode. And the great thing is that all of your progression for each character carries across both modes. The inspiration of the game came from movies like Mission Impossible, and we like the dry wits, you know, we like the espionage elements and some of the charm of the characters and the exotic locations. But we also love making creative weapons, and the more we started thinking about this alien substance powering them, we drew inspiration from District 9. And so we thought the pairing of these two different types of genres and movies could create something really cool.
So I played a little bit of the game, and I noticed that there's like a score system. Can you talk a little bit about how that works and how the teamwork interacts with the score system?
Sure. So if you work together, you're going to earn more XP, and you're going to be able to upgrade your characters faster. And that's an incentive to play together as a team. If I'm Dalton Brooks and I have my mag shield up, and someone fires through it and kills an enemy, like if Jacob were to fire his arc shot through it, both of us actually get more points than if we were just to kill the enemy alone. You get even greater, more exponential points if three or four people are working together. So, you know, for instance, Izzy could crystallize a group of enemies, Dalton could bring up his mag shield, Jacob could fire through it and shatter all of them, and you just rack up all the points. Then you can use those points to purchase upgrades for your characters and upgrade.
So what kind of upgrades do you earn? Is it weapons, additional powers, that kind of thing?
Well, each character has their own unique skill tree, and so you start out with your base weapon. Dalton Brooks just has a mag shield. And then as he earns fuse points, he can then upgrade it to become deployable where he drops it. Jacob Kimball starts off with just the arc shot firing bolts. He can't do burn damage until he upgrades that. Nia Devereaux doesn't start cloaking until she gets that upgrade. And Izzy Sinclair can't start healing until she does as well. Find a great way for people to kind of jump into the game, understand the basics of their character. And then as they get those fuse points, they start to learn more and more about what they upgrade.
Awesome. So that's co-op, but there's also a multiplayer element, and you already mentioned it's the Echelon mode. Can you tell us a little bit about like how that works and what it is?
Sure. So you know, Echelon is a round-based mode, and it's random on what the objectives are for each round. We lock in round 6 and round 12, where you're fighting mini-bosses. So the way it works is if I jump in Echelon mode, I'm in one of the 6 maps that is based off of the campaign levels. So what we're showing here is Shang Island, where we're fighting around a large submarine in this bay location. And essentially, you go from round to round. And so we've got Critical Drop, where there's a supply drop that you have to go after. We've got Countdown Mode, where you're carrying a fuse cell, and you have to protect the teammate who's carrying it. We've got Hot Zone, where there's a fuse cell that everyone has to rally behind and keep their fuse weapons powered up. We've got, I'm trying to think of all of them, a Carnage Mode, where there's a lot of enemies that you just have to take out in one particular area. And then we have Primal Threat, which is the Enforcer robot boss that you fight at the very end, which is in round 12. And then halfway through the game, you have to fight a high-value target, which is like a heavy-type enemy that you have to take out. So you never know what you're going to get as you're playing through Echelon mode. The objectives are always changing, and it's going to be a challenging mode. It really forces people to work together, and you really feel like you earn each round as you get through them.
So it sounds like Fuse is made for a four-player co-op mode. What if you don't have that many friends, or you just want to play on your own? Is that also available?
Well, if you're like me, I tend to play most of my games single-player first, and then if I really get into it, I join it with a buddy later on. And so we're designing this game so it's fun single-player, too. What we've got is this feature called Leap, which allows you to leap between characters. So if I'm playing single player, it still feels like a team. I'm playing with AI bots, and at any point, I can jump into those AI bots and use them. And the great thing is that I can level them up and progress them. So we really give players a lot of chances on how they want to play the game, a lot of different opportunities for playing the game from different perspectives. And of course, Leap works not only in single player, but if you're playing two player or three player. All you need is an AI bot to leap into that character.
Cool, sounds awesome. So when can we expect to play Fuse, and for what platforms?
Fuse is coming out for the PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360 in spring 2013.
Awesome. So for more on Fuse, be sure to check out GamesRadar.com. And thanks a lot.
Great. Thank you.